Year in political history, or the final year in political history, there is no doubt that an entire year's worth of political news was crammed into each week of 2017. And our Jake Tapper is here to sort out the biggest stories of a wild first year of President Trump.
Gather around, family and friends. You'll be talking about 2017 for generations to come. The first year of the Trump presidency shattered the status quo. Cultures of harassment were exposed, travel bans were debated, protests erupted, and I seem to recall something about Russia. Here are, in our view, the top seven political stories of 2017.
President Trump signed executive orders banning U.S. entry from seven Muslim-majority nations, which sparked worldwide protests and disagreement among the courts before a revised version was upheld.
We're going to take our case as far as it needs to go, including all the way up to the Supreme Court.
The administration also ended the DACA program, affecting some 700,000 undocumented immigrants brought to the U.S. as children.
The DACA policy produced by the last administration could not be sustained.
The fate of these so-called dreamers was left in the hands of Congress.
Hopefully, now Congress will be able to help them and do it properly.
Mr. President, I will not be complicit or silent.
In 2017, some Republicans went rogue, openly displaying disdain for the president of their own party.
I think the debasement of our nation will be what he'll be remembered most for.
Critics such as Jeff Flake of Arizona and former Trump supporter Bob Corker of Tennessee announced they would not seek re-election to the Senate.
It's not enough to be conservative anymore. It seems that you have to be angry about it.
Both will remain in office until November, working with Republican Senators John McCain, Ben Sass, and Cory Gardner, who have expressed condemnation of Trump at different times as well.
We're going to get a health bill passed. We're going to get health care taken care of in this country.
Republicans tried to repeal and replace Obamacare, received insufficient support, removed the bill, regrouped, and were left reeling after repeat defeats.
The motion is not agreed to.
The most dramatic, courtesy of Republican John McCain.
We promised to repeal and replace Obamacare, and we failed.
The GOP had no major legislative victory all year until December.
Merry Christmas, America.
A $1.5 trillion GOP tax plan passed with a partial repeal of Obamacare, handwritten edits, and absolutely no Democratic support. A white supremacist rally in Charlottesville, Virginia, began with a torchlit march around a Confederate monument. One of these white supremacists rammed his car into a crowd, killing 32-year-old Heather Heyer. The president initially failed to call out the white supremacists.
I think there's blame on both sides.
Even strong conservatives condemned his response.
What Trump did today was a moral disgrace.
Passionate demonstrations filled the streets.
Nazis are not welcome here.
And nationwide symbols of the Confederacy were vandalized or officially removed.
You're fired.
It was more than a catchphrase. Just ask Press Secretary Sean Spicer or Communications Director Anthony Scaramucci or Chief of Staff Reince Priebus or Chief Strategist Steve Bannon or National Security Advisor Michael Flynn. And of course,
why do you believe you were fired?
I take the president at his word that I was fired because of the Russia investigation.
The Trump administration had more than a dozen resignations, firings, and reassignments in its first year. The Me Too movement ushered in an era of accountability, ending careers and launching a battle for moral high ground. Allegations that Republican Roy Moore sexually assaulted teen girls as an adult led Alabama voters to elect their first Democratic senator in 25 years.
I am leaving while a man who has bragged on tape about his history of sexual assault sits in the Oval Office.
Fellow Democrats forced Senator Al Franken to announce his resignation after several women said he acted inappropriately.
He just mashes his mouth to my lips.
Several others in Congress, including Trent Franks, John Conyers, Reuben Kuhn, and Blake Farenthold, resigned or announced early retirements after facing accusations of their own. But in response to questions about the president's past actions, the White House was defiant.
That's the big news here, is the Russian interference in our election system.
The leaders of U.S. intelligence agencies unanimously concluded that Russia interfered in the presidential election. But did President Trump's campaign help them in their effort?
I have nothing to do with Russia.
FBI Director James Comey was leading the investigation until he was fired. Now, an investigation by special counsel Robert Mueller is digging deeper. Former National Security Advisor Michael Flynn pleaded guilty to misleading the FBI, and campaign chairman Paul Manafort was indicted. The Senate Intelligence Committee questioned Donald Trump Jr. for hours about his meetings with Russians in Trump Tower.
Is he being forthcoming?
There are a lot of legitimate questions that this individual needs to answer.
All this as the president and his supporters, playing defense, tried to accuse the Mueller investigation of bias.
Those were our top seven political stories of 2017, but with the Russia investigation still ongoing and control of the Senate at stake, 2018 is sure to present unprecedented political headlines of its own.